I am Serin Jung. Today I will talk about the quantum Hall effect in graphene, which is one of the most fascinating phenomena in quantum mechanics. In classical physics, the Hall effect describes how the current flowing through a sample will be affected by the application of a magnetic field. Consider a two-dimensional conducting plate with an applied electric field. Without the magnetic field, the electron will move in a negative direction of the current. However, in the presence of an applied magnetic field, the electron in the plate will actually flow in a direction perpendicular to the current. Here, the voltage because of the Hall effect is defined as IB over NTE. Also, we can measure the Hall resistance RH. It is equals to minus 1 over NE. From the Hall resistance, we can get transverse and longitudinal resistivity. The transverse resistivity of classical Hall effect is proportional to the magnetic field strength. On the other hand, the longitudinal resistivity is m over n squared tau, which is always constant. The quantum Hall effect is quantized version of Hall effect, which is observed in two-dimensional electron systems with low temperature and a strong magnetic field. Unlike the classical Hall effect, the Hall resistivity of the system does not vary linearly with the strength of the magnetic field. This result indicates that the Hall resistance is quantized. The Hall resistance of quantum Hall effect is half over nu square. As you can see here, the Hall resistance is quantized in units of half over e square, and it is inversely proportional to the certain constant. Before we deal with the details about the quantum Hall effect, I will introduce several backgrounds for this concept. There are two important concepts to analyze the graphene quantum Hall effect: Landau level and the filling factor. First of all, Landau quantization refers to the quantization of cyclotron orbits of charged particles in a uniform magnetic field. Then the charged particles occupy orbits with discrete and equally spaced energy levels. And we called this equidistant energy level Landau level. The mathematical form of a Landau level is 1 over 2 plus n multiple half a qb over mc. Another feature in describing the quantum Hall effect is the filling factor. As I mentioned before, the Hall resistance of the quantum Hall effect is quantized, and it is inversely proportional to the certain constant. We call this constant filling factor. Filling factor is the number of occupied Landau levels for electrons in a given magnetic field, and it defines as follows. The filling factor is a measure of both the magnetic field and the number of occupied Landau level. Here, the number of electrons that can exist in a given Landau level increases proportionally with the magnetic field strength. If the magnetic field strength increases fewer, then fewer Landau levels are occupied. Okay, now we can talk about the quantum Hall effect. Coming back to the equation of Hall resistance, depending on whether the filling factor is integer or fraction, we call this effect the integer or fractional quantum Hall effect, respectively. First, the integer quantum Hall effect is described in a system of non-interacting electrons where the highest Landau level is completely filled. As the magnetic field strength increases, the gap between Landau levels becomes wider. When the Fermi level is placed in the middle of the gap between Landau levels, the energetically lower Landau level is completely filled with electrons, whereas the energetically higher Landau level is wholly empty. When there is a match between the capacity of Landau levels and the number of electrons in the sample, the integer number of the Landau level is exactly filled, so we get the integer quantum Hall effect in this case. On the other hand, the origin of a fractional quantum Hall effect is interaction between electrons. Unlike the integer quantum Hall effect, there is much space in a Landau level. Therefore, the electrons have a freedom to avoid each other in the energetically most advantageous fashion. Thus, the Landau level is partially filled and the fractional quantum Hall effect happens. Then, how we can apply these phenomena in graphene? Graphene is a single layer of carbon atoms in a two-dimensional hexagonal lattice. The carbon atom bonds to one another via covalent bonds, leaving one 2p orbital electron. Therefore, the result is that the Fermi surface of graphene is characterized by 6 double cones. Interestingly, both integer and fractional quantum Hall effects happen when the magnetic field is applied to the graphene. Then let's take a look at the integer quantum Hall effect first. By some successful experimental works and several theoretical attempts, the Hall conductivity of integer quantum Hall effect in graphene is established as follows. 4 multiple n plus 1 over 2 multiple e squared super half. Here, n is an integer including 0. The prefactor 4 reflects the 2-fold spin and 2-fold valley degeneracy in the graphene band structure. The term 1 over 2 comes from the pseudo-spin precession when a particle exercises cyclotron motion. Also, the fractional quantum Hall effect can be observed in the graphene when the magnetic field is applied. Theoretically, this phenomenon happens when the filling factor is n over 2n plus 1 and n over 2n minus 1. However, the value of the filling factor in reality is slightly different from the theoretical one. We can explain this difference with the direction of an applied magnetic field and the Landau level mixing in graphene. I hope this video helped you to understand the graphene quantum Hall effect. Thank you for listening, and this is the reference.